Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. Let's start the current affairs for today, that is 31st of August. Today is the last day of the month, so let's try to be quick with this one. And from tomorrow, it will be business as usual. We'll start with the current affairs right at the time that is designated for the English current affairs, that is 9 a.m. I would like to remind you that our pen drive courses sale is on till 4th of September. This is our Janmashtami sale, so you can make best use of it. Now, before I start the video, I'll show you two images. And the first one is a temple. It's a temple which is in Odisha, and it's a temple of Lord Shiva. Can you identify the temple? See it nicely, and if you see it closely, you can also identify the architecture of this temple. And the second one is a dam. Now all dams, they look the same. So I'll tell you the name of this dam. It is called Jawahar Sagar. Jawahar Sagar. Can you tell me where is it, which state, and on which river? You need to tell me both of the answers right now before even finishing the video. So take a good look at this dam. Okay. So central government has signed $375 million loan agreement with Asian Development Bank. For which state's irrigation efficiency improvement project? So this state wants to improve its irrigation efficiency, and for that it is getting a loan of $375 million from Asian Development Bank ADB, which is headquartered in Manila. The state I'm talking about is Madhya Pradesh. But remember that today, that is 31st of August, we have got not one but three loans, right? Not one. So MP we have already seen. MP is getting a loan of $375 million for irrigation. Second loan that we have got today is $346 million loan, but that is for Karnataka, and that is not for irrigation, it is for road connectivity. So Karnataka in 12 districts, 400 kilometers roads, total length 400 kilometers, they will be improved, they will be repaired, and for that $346 million is required, and this will be financed by ADB once again. And the third loan that we are getting is a drinking water project for West Bengal. $245 million loan, again by ADB, and this will benefit around 1.65 million people. And these are the people who have been affected by polluted water because of arsenic or high salinity, etc. So let's quickly revise. First loan, Madhya Pradesh irrigation, $375 million. Second, Karnataka roads, $346 million. And third is West Bengal drinking water project, $245 million. Now, the Union Cabinet has given its approval for revision of the project outlay for setting up of India Post Payment Bank from 800 crore to how much? So basically, India Post Payment Bank, right? It's a payment bank, and it is the only government or public sector payment bank. Remember that. In fact, a lot of payment banks, they have opened recently. Like we have the Jio Payment Bank, okay, Reliance Jio Payment Bank. We have Vodafone and Idea, Aditya Birla Payment Bank. Then we have Fino Payment Bank. So a lot of these payment banks have opened, but all are private. India Post is the only government payment bank, and they want to open 650 branches. So to open 650 branches, you need cash. So earlier the allocation was 800 crore. Now it has been increased to 1435 crore. So India Post Payment Bank, remember their tagline is Aapke bank, aapke dwar, right? Which means your bank at your door. Okay, aapke bank, aapke dwar. And managing director and chief executive officer of this bank is Suresh Sethi. Central government has signed a memorandum of understanding between India and which country in the field of railways. So we will mutually cooperate with each other for development, enhancement of railways. This country is South Korea. South Korea's currency is won, capital is Seoul, and president is Mr. Moon Jae-in. Union Cabinet has signed a tripartite, which means three-party agreement between India and which other two countries? We will cooperate in the field of animal husbandry, dairying, and fisheries. Fisheries. These two countries are UK and Northern Ireland. Although Northern Ireland is a part of UK, but okay, we have signed separately with UK and Northern Ireland. Northern Ireland's capital, very few people know, is Belfast. Which country is using Kiko robots to teach the kindergarten children? Kindergarten children are basically very, very young who go to play schools and, you know, the very early classes. And Kiko robot, what is this? So it's only a 60 centimeter robot. It's a very small robot, because if it was very big, then it could probably have overwhelmed small children. It could have scared them. So it's a small robot, just 60 centimeter. It's being used in China. And this robot will tell various stories to children. It will play with children. So, well, we have interesting times here. Look at the robot. And you can see Chinese tots. Chinese tots are playing with this cute robot, which is called Kiko. Now, the shipping and railway ministries, along with the Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra government, they have entered into an agreement to implement ₹-crore Indore to Manmad rail project. Indore is in Madhya Pradesh, Manmad is in Maharashtra. There will be a railway link that will be set up, and for this, how much amount has been allocated? It is 9,000 crore. This is very, very important. I'll tell you why. So look at the map. Now, this is called JNPT or Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust. It is also called Nhava Sheva Port, very near to Mumbai. Now, if you go from JNPT to Indore, you have to cover all the way to Surat, to Vadodara, to Ratlam Junction and to Indore. This distance is 805 kilometers, right? But if you take the smaller route, then from JNPT, you have a train route till Nashik, right? And till Manmad. But you don't have from Manmad to Indore. So now from Indore to Manmad, there will be a railway project. And for this, 9,000 crore will be spent. So now you don't have to travel 815 kilometers. You just have to travel 362 and 282. So in effect, you will save around 150 kilometer, which is around 1.5 hours of your time going at a normal railway speed in India, which is around 110 or 100 kilometers an hour. State Bank of India has merged. You know that State Bank of India has merged with its associate banks, five associate banks and Bharatiya Mahila Bank. So it has merged with six associate banks. Total six, five associate and one Bharatiya Mahila. Bharatiya Mahila is not an associate bank. So if they ask overall, it has merged with how many associate banks? The answer is five. Total banks, how many it has merged with? The answer is six, right? Now, after merging, it has changed the IFSC code of how many branches? It has changed the IFSC code of 1300 branches. Now, remember IFSC code. Can you tell me what is the full form of IFSC? Write down in comments. Now, IFSC is an 11 digits alphanumeric code. What is the meaning of alphanumeric? Alphanumeric simply means it has numbers also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and all. And it has alphabets also, like A, B, C, D, etc. So it's an 11 digit alphanumeric code. And remember, the fifth digit in an IFSC code is always 0. Which place has become the wettest place in India this year, leaving behind Meghalaya's Cherrapunji? So we receive maximum rainfall in Cherrapunji in Meghalaya every year. And remember, near Cherrapunji, there's a place called Mohsen Ram. It is said to be the wettest place in the world. By wettest, I mean the maximum rainfall ever recorded in history has been recorded actually from Mohsen Ram. So, but one place in Maharashtra has even surpassed Cherrapunji this year, right? Which place is that? It is Mahabaleshwar. Mahabaleshwar is in Satara district in Maharashtra. Now, let me show you why Mahabaleshwar is famous. The most important is the Panch Ganga temple. Okay, Panch means five. Panch Ganga temple. It is called Panch Ganga because five rivers, they take origin from here. Okay, which five rivers originate from Panch Ganga temple? Gayatri river, Savitri river, Koyna river, Vena river and Krishna river. The most important is of course Krishna, it is the largest. But Koyna is also equally important. And on the Vena river, you have the famous Vena lake also in Satara. And there is one more temple, which is called Krishnabai temple in Mahabaleshwar. Krishnabai temple. Arunachal cabinet has passed a bill for creation of how many new districts? So how many new districts will be made in Arunachal Pradesh? CM is Pema Khandu and three new districts will be made. Which three new districts we will have? So first is called the Pakke Kesang district. Pakke Kesang district, which will be carved out from East Kameng. And then Lower Siang district will be bifurcated and a new district called Leparada will be created. And the third district will be called Shi Yomi district in the West Siang. It will be cut off. It will be, you know, carved out from West Siang, this one. You must have heard this word Pakke before. I told you there is a Pakke Tiger Reserve. Now you know it is in Arunachal. It is also called Pakhui Tiger Reserve, by the way. Two names. And this, you know, this East Kameng is very popular because of elephants. There is a very huge elephant reserve in East Kameng. And there is a wildlife sanctuary also. Who has been appointed as India's next High Commissioner to United Kingdom? So United Kingdom, you know, it is the headquarter of Commonwealth, and that is why we are using the word High Commissioner. The word ambassador we use in non-Commonwealth countries. So the person is Ruchi Ghanshyam. The Ministry of Tourism, who is our tourism minister? KJ Alphonse. Where is he from? He is from Kerala, but he is a Rajya Sabha member of parliament from Rajasthan. He has been elected to the Rajya Sabha from Rajasthan. So the Ministry of Tourism has sanctioned two new projects under the Heritage and Northeast Circuit. One type of circuit is Heritage Circuit, second type of circuit is Northeast Circuit. Like that, we have different thematic circuits like Wildlife Circuit or, you know, Desert Circuit and all that. Now this is a part of the Swadesh Darshan scheme of the Ministry of Tourism, and the total amount that will be spent is 164.95 crore in which two states? So Heritage Circuit will be built in Punjab and Northeast Circuit will be built in Tripura. So the answer is D, Punjab and Tripura. And the circuit will cover these areas: Anandapur Sahib to Fatehgarh Sahib, Chamkaur Sahib, Firozpur, Amritsar, Khatkar, Kalan, Kalanaur and Patiala. Now remember, Anandapur Sahib is the place where a museum called Virasat-e-Khalsa is being set up. This was announced by the Tourism Minister of Punjab, Navjot Singh Sidhu. There is a museum, you know, depicting the history of Sikhism that is called Virasat-e-Khalsa that will be set up in Anandapur Sahib. And then we have Fatehgarh Sahib, where we have the, there was a person called Shaheed Uddham Singh, you remember? Freedom fighter, revolutionary, Shaheed Uddham Singh. So his body was, the last rites were done in Fatehgarh Sahib. And then we have Chamkaur Sahib, Firozpur, Amritsar. Amritsar is Golden Temple City. We have Jallianwala Bagh also here. And then there will be a Northeast Circuit in Tripura. So these are the places which it will connect, and the cost will be 65 crore, and for Punjab it will be 99.95. So total cost will be 164.95 crore. Which region in India has commissioned a black hole pump? What this pump will do? First of all, this pump has been designed by Tesla, right? This pump has been designed by the company Tesla. It will tackle the waste problem. How? It will convert all the waste into, you know, except glass, to ash. It will burn it down. And it won't use fuel also, it won't use electricity also, but still it will convert all the waste into ash. And this place has been really struggling because of the waste. Daily 15 to 16 million ton of waste is produced, and it is Ladakh. And this is because of excessive tourism in Ladakh, that so much waste is generated every day. So the answer is Ladakh. What is the difference between Ladakh and Leh? So Leh is a district, and Ladakh is a mountain chain which is a part of the Trans-Himalayas. Now remember, Leh, it is the second largest district of India. Leh is the second largest district of India after Kutch, if I talk about area. Okay, Kutch is in Gujarat. Which state government has recently signed a memorandum of understanding with an America-based agency called Malaria No More and an Indian agency called Malaria Elimination Trust? So basically they want to make the state malaria free. This is Odisha. Why was Odisha in news? Because they have got legislative council, becoming the 8th state in India to have a legislative council. And malaria, well, we want to eliminate it, and it is caused by female Anopheles mosquito. Okay, and remember, the program name for elimination of malaria is called Daman, D-A-M-A-N, Daman program. The Reserve Bank of India has released its annual report. Now, it has mentioned that India's GDP will grow in the present financial year, that is from 1st of April 2018 to 31st March 2019, okay, at what percent? And remember, last year, that is 2017-18, our GDP growth was 6.7%. This year, it will be 7.4%, according to Reserve Bank of India. The Union Cabinet, chaired by the Prime Minister Modi, has approved the revised air services agreement to be signed between India and which country? This will be signed between India and Morocco. Now I told you North Africa, the way to remember it is male T. T is Tunisia, Morocco, Algeria, Libya, Egypt. These are the North African countries. So why was Morocco in news? First of all, Morocco's capital is Rabat, R-A-B-A-T. Morocco was in news because the Football World Cup for 2026 will be played in three countries put together: Canada, America and Mexico. They had a joint bid and they had defeated the bid of Morocco. Right, they were awarded the bid to host the Football World Cup in 2026 by defeating the bid of Morocco. Remember that. And of course, in 2022, we will have the World Cup in Qatar. I'm talking about FIFA Football World Cup. The central government has approved a memorandum of understanding between the insurance regulator in India, which is called IRDAI, Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India. It is headed by Subhash Chandra Khuntia. He is the chairman of IRDAI and the insurance office of which country? This is the insurance office of, you have four options, America. So America's insurance regulator and India's insurance regulator, they will mutually cooperate. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has given its approval for, you know, there is an Ocean Development Umbrella Scheme, and it will be implemented for a period of 3 years from 2017-18 all the way till 2020 at an overall cost of 1623 crore. What is the name of that Ocean Development Scheme? It will be called OSMART. OSMART. Now, this scheme has been started by the Ministry of Earth Sciences, headed by Dr. Harshvardhan. He is also the Minister for Science and Technology and also for Environment, Forest and Climate Change. And OSMART stands for Ocean Services, Technology, Observations, Resource Modeling and Science. Now, why is this started? This is started, you know, as a, disaster management resource. It will be a disaster management resource. And the Ministry of Earth Sciences, if you remember, they had also launched a mobile app called Sagar Vani. Sagar Vani, to basically disseminate the information if any disaster is imminent, then the information can be disseminated at a much faster pace using Sagar Vani mobile app. The Union Cabinet has approved the signing of Memorandum of Understanding between India and which country for strengthening the cooperation in the field of tourism. We will cooperate in the field of tourism with Bulgaria. Bulgaria is a European country, capital is Sofia. Let me show you where is Bulgaria. So you have, this is the Scandinavia, this is Europe, and come to the southeast part of Europe, you will find Bulgaria, neighbor of Romania, Serbia, Macedonia, etc. So this is Bulgaria right here, and it is right at the coast formed by Black Sea. Who were the first Europeans to come to India? The first Europeans, you remember Vasco da Gama? So he was a Portuguese. So Portuguese were the first and Dutch were the second. Dutch are the people from Holland. Holland is also called Netherlands. Which among the following is the world's largest wetland system? It is formed by three countries, right? It is called Pantanal. Pantanal is the largest wetland system in the world. It is in South America. Let me show you where it is. So by now you must be well versed with the map of South America. You have Brazil here, you have Bolivia, and you have Paraguay. So this is Pantanal, right? 80% of it lies in Brazil, but the remaining 20% is shared by Bolivia and Paraguay. Paraguay's capital is Asuncion. Bolivia has two capitals. One is called Sucre and one is called La Paz. And Brazil is Brasilia. And somewhere here you have Rio de Janeiro, which hosted the Olympic Games in 2016 and also the FIFA Football World Cup in 2014. All the species of lemur, they are endemic to which place in the world? Where will you find lemur? It is a monkey-like looking primate. It belongs to primate. It's a mammal. It belongs to Madagascar. Where is Madagascar? It is to the east of Africa, South Africa. So you see here, this is South Africa. And right here in the Indian Ocean, you will have Madagascar in the Indian Ocean. Which Indian sprinter has clinched the gold medal in the men's 1500 meter event in the Asian Games 2018? What is his name? His name is Jinson Johnson and he is from Kerala. Also remember Manjeet Singh. If you remember, Manjeet Singh had won the gold medal in the 800 meter race. He finished 4th in the 1500 meter. And Manjeet Singh is from Jind in Haryana. According to Reserve Bank of India annual report, what percent of demonetized currency is back in the banks? This demonetized currency was worth 15.3 lakh crore. And it consisted of two types of notes only, 500 rupee and 1000 demonetized notes. 99.3% is back in the system and only 0.7% we can say was the black money. Cambodia has signed a memorandum of understanding with India for the restoration and preservation of its 11th century AD temple, which is called Priya Vihar. India will help Cambodia with the restoration and preservation of Priya Vihar temple. This temple is dedicated to which god? It is dedicated to God Shiva. Cambodia, by the way, also has one of the largest Hindu temples in the world, which is called Angkor Wat. Angkor Wat temple. Okay, so this was the video for today, 31st of August. See you tomorrow, and I'll be on time, 9 a.m. Thank you so much. Bye.